it's like.
Yeah, man, I played this game for many years. This is my serious game between about 2002 and 2007.
Right,
you were a Q user, right?
I did use Q, yeah.
It's a troll. You like Dan and Q.
This is back in the day. I wouldn't do it over again, but at the time, I had a great time playing Q. You know, I never won tournaments with him, but I got top eights at some big stuff, and he definitely had some vocals.
Yeah.
Never that top tier of a player, though.
I mean, I hate revealing my age, but I missed Third Strike because I just graduated college when it came out.
Nice.
And that's where I played most of my games. And here we go. Oh, that can hit. Very hard to connect, though. Very hard to link.
Alright, this is probably going to be stun. Yep. He wanted to make sure that he would get the stun with the EX. Even though super, you know, he only has one super meter over there with SA3, but just make totally sure.
Yeah, one of the cool things, actually, I've always really liked Makoto's voice actor in this game. They actually got her back to do the Street Fighter 4 Japanese voice.
Oh, it's the same one?
Yeah, so it's actually really cool.
That is pretty cool, yeah. Mike C really likes Tsurugi. He's been doing that all day. Makoto not caught in the corner here. Oh, just goes for throw. Might have been able to do low medium kick super.
Oh, nice dash cover right at the last second.
Makoto
gets so low and she dashes so fast that it's really hard to see coming a lot of the time.
Oh, back dash out of it.
I'm not sure if he tried to carry that. Oh, once again, Shin Chang missing that combo.
The reason to start off with the command grab there is for the extra stun it deals. That's really what Makoto's game is oftentimes about.
Wow, did you see him just kind of stare him down right there?
That's his game, and I love that part about the game. Oh, man. Is he going to go for EX? Oh, he's going for super combos. No, he missed it.
Wow.
Maybe it was a reset, actually. I don't know.
Yeah,
but yeah.
Sniffed it out.
Take it for a time.
Oh.
Yeah. Mike has to wake up and parry. Without being able to block with that super, you have to wake up parry. And you might ask yourself, that great a super? Is that a great super? Because it doesn't seem like it. The answer is no.
It's not a good super.
But that's Mike Z. He's always gone with it.
Yeah, and that's what he's known for. So. Definitely, I would have to say that probably 99% of the Makoto fans who will see play this game will use Super Art 1 and 2. And they're equally as useful, too. There's no preferences between them. It is very seriously, one is better on most characters than the other.
I mean, definitely on some characters, you want SA2 to deal with the 100% stun combos that she can get. That's extremely important. But some people like the extra hit confirm ability and combo ability of Super Art 1. Super Art 2, you can only combo. Interesting, because Makoto is one of the few characters in Street Fighter history that, in some sense, prefers to be in the corner. Because that's the only time when Fierce into SA2 actually works.
Right. And you can actually simulate that distance a lot of times just by, like, doing a cross up medium kick. The screen won't scroll as far so you can actually land that combo. So there's a lot of ways to do it, even if you aren't physically in the corner.
And you know what I always used to use as the judge? Was the timer. Where is she relative to the timer?
Good call.
If she's just near the corner than the timer is, then I'm good.
Right. But Super Art 1 can be comboed off of... Oh!
And in back dash, if you look for something, look at all the extra damage there.
I know.
Oh man, he hasn't guessed right one time. There was every time that Shin knocked him down, he went for the target combo, which has to be parried toward. But Mike Z, I think, looked for a low parry each time. Just guess wrong. Too bad for Mike. Here comes Alex Sanchez again. Yeah, this time it's going to be Alex versus Mike.
For Shin, y'all.
Yeah, Shin is done. Out of Texas. Awesome play from him. Up next is going to be Sanchez and Mike Z. Two LA players. They've played each other quite a bit.
Save the replay, please.
All right.
Yeah, awesome. Sanchez going to be going with Alex, as he always does, his eponymously named
Alex is not considered a top-tier character. He's probably bottom-middle tier.
He's a low-mid character. Oh, he goes with Q! Yes! This is, in my opinion, one of the worst matchups in Street Fighter history.
Makoto and Q.
Makoto and Q. She has every advantage at almost all times.
And Q actually is very.
That top will give him extra extra damage.
Yeah, you can get.
Sorry, extra life.
Yeah, you can get three of them in one round, but he has to finish the taunt.
Actually, no. All that has to happen is that the screen needs to shake.
Oh, really?
Yep.
That's awesome. Oh, so you get hit on the taunt, so you actually can't keep it up. Nice.
Oh, trying for tricks. That is punishable. Nicely done.
Yeah. I mean, it's kind of interesting because Q is kind of the, quote, Balrog, unquote, of the game, being able to do the straight punch, that's the punch. Overhead punch, and the low punch.
But he plays very, very differently. He's kind of a defensive zoning character. He does have mix-ups of posts that are damaging, but the problem is he just rarely gets a chance to use them.
Right. And he's also got a command throw, too.
Right. Capture and deadly blow. Alex jumping right out. And yeah, I see it's very difficult to react to things. And
perfectly timed to meet. He's strong medium punch there.
I want super. I just want random super. Thank you!
Oh, no! Oh, my God!
There's one of the advantages. Q can actually be thrown. Q can be thrown out of both of his supers, SA1, SA2, by Karakusa, Makoto's grab. And she can also just low short right under
apparently
super
so.
Q.
I mean, here we have this giant guy with a metal face swinging his fist the hardest strength possible. And she's like, no, blink. It's like lightning taps him in the foot.
That's right. On Q's wake up, if she does her command grab, he has no options but jump. And even if he jumps, he recovers in time to parry all of his jump attacks.
Wow.
It's not a good situation. Obviously, you're not going to go to it every time, because then your damage output is just not going to be that great. But if she wants to, she can do it.
Oh, nice. Avoiding, just getting right over the stomp. Oh, caught him. If you only hit with a second hit, you can juggle with that.
Nice to rip.
Oh, great dodge there. Actually was able to punish it. Oh, I was surprised he did not go for us. I swore Mike was going to go for the Fukuyaki there. Punch him out of the air, but...
That would have been cool. Maybe that's why Sage wasn't pressing the button. Maybe he was looking to parry.
That's true. Oh, nice.
Big throw. Gives him time to dash up again. Oh, did he get it in time? No, not quite.
But it still grabs.
Wow. It's a grab at the end. You gotta jump out of it or hit it beforehand. Wow, good night.
Right. Street Fighter Third Strike has this mechanic where there's a certain real animation where you get hit and you turn with your back facing the opponent. Certain moves like the flash chop from Alex and the fourth hit of the boomerang raid and stuff like the Kuma standing roundhouse will cause that real animation. And when those real animations occur, you can combo throws. And so that's why you can actually do stand roundhouse and arranging demon with the Kuma and actually get that to connect.
Necro has some of that stuff too. Wow, he's really fishing for the back pierce. And this game has some funny things where they can be blocked but not parried, and that back pierce is one of them.
Oh, nice.
Lots of stun. Watch out. There it is. No, he didn't get a follow-up.
And Alex is going to get out of that dizzy situation with two throws. And a fake throw right there, right in the stand.
In this game, you're dizzy defensively nearly as fast. If you get close to dizzy, it's hard to get away from it.
Yep. Also,
in Street Fighter 4, your dizzy doesn't go down until you stop walking.
Right.
But this one, it goes down while blocking, just that it goes down so slowly.
Right. And also to note, for Alex, Super R2 is always going to be his best choice just to get access to that EX flash shot.
Oh.
Went for it that time. And it misses with
he tried to punish, so that would have been, I believe, stun. Wow, he's getting crazy now.
Nice. Like I said, that EX flash chop, so important to Alex to be able to have that option there, which is one of his best punishes. I mean, I think someone noted before that using the boomerang raid to hit somebody when they're dizzy does only a tiny bit more damage than a jump attack stand medium into EX flash chop for much less meter.
Harry? No, not quite.
Wow. Even if she has a move sticking into her when she activates her super,
Oh, no, he just went into throw. Why? Man, you're going to deal so much damage. She killed the two combos.
Great. Great leads there from Mike C. Oh, he's going to be able to juggle. And what mix-ups do we have here?
Oh, Mike blocking it correctly. There it is.
Oh, there. Oh,
no, Alex. Alex is not going to be happy about that.
Oh, great dodge there.
There it is. And there's no Cat Daddy this time.
Give it up for Mike B, y'all.
Alright, Mike C stepping off.
Sanchez. Alright, this is not a good look because it's going to be Alex versus Chun-Li. Not an easy matchup.
Yeah. I mean, interestingly enough, in this game, the tier list in general, like, not, of course, it's not exactly like this, but most of the characters, you lose to all the people who are above you in the tier list, and you beat all the people under you in the tier list.
It mostly is like that. This game is actually... Oh, really? Okay. This game is actually pretty well balanced if you look at it as being like an 8 or 9 character game. Beyond that, things start to get a little wonky, and I know that in Japan, they've, you know, continued to break down characters and matchups, and that things like, you know, Hugo's gone up in the tiers, Q's gone up in the tiers a little bit, but still, it's definitely the case that, for the most part, lower tier character will lose to a higher tier character.
And I'm not going to explain how it works, because it's super complicated, but there is a technique known as charge partitioning that helps a lot of charge-up characters be able to be mobile and still keep their charge going up.
Well, basically, I mean, you know, we can talk about the real fast. The basic idea behind it is that you can interrupt your charge. You can split it in half.
Right.
Oh, that's not going to work.
Only
you can split it in half, and that means that you can do things like charge, dash, then do your charge move.
Right.
You can do charge, stop charging, recharge again during your dash, and when you finish your dash, it's ready to go.
Basically, there's just a very small frame window that you can stop charging and get back to charging. Oh, no,
and that's
far
useful
away.
For characters like Remy, and extremely important for Yuri, because some of his combos and unblockables require it. Oh, no hit confirmed. That close beat can be hit confirmed in the SA2. Nice, you can hit confirms. In this game, you can cancel right out of chain attacks, unlike in Street Fighter 4.
Right. Yeah, actually, most Capcom games let you do that. The only ones that don't are Street Fighter 4 and the original series.
Although in SF2 you can trick the system by switching from a low chain to a high chain,
oh, yeah, that's
and
right.
Then cancel the high chain move immediately. But right. Street Fighter 4 doesn't have that. So is it time to play a serious character?
Looks like it.
Not that Remy's terrible, but neither one is a Remy player.
Oh, Denshin Hadouken!
The SoCal special! Denshin Hadouken!
Yep.
That's right. We made this famous. Frankie really made it. He's the one who made it famous.
And second impact, because Denshin Hadouken was so powerful, and it was weakened in this version. Just because they changed it from being able to have two of them to only one of them. Actually, I think it was the original one that had two of them. I don't remember when they made that change now. It's too long ago. I can't remember that far back.
Yeah, I was taking it back to where you had to. And there, you see the use of the parry that he actually wanted as a part of the parry? You can throw somebody when they're in parry stun.
Right.
So he set out Sonic Boom, and when Amir parried, that gave him a free throw.
And a little step kick that Remy did there. Was that an overhead, or is that
not an overhead?
You know what? I don't recall. Remy tore mini kick overhead or not? It is, right? Yeah.
Because it doesn't look like one, which is why it's so confusing to me. Yeah, I mean, there's a way, like, you can set up a charge partitioning sequence so that Remy can just throw high, low, high, low, high, low. Very tricky to set up.
Jump right over it. That super is not blockable. It deals full stun and charge. Oh, no, not in time.
Big damage time. Maybe he thought he was going to land on the other side.
He's going to get another chance. Here it is.
Oh,
there it is. You have to parry it. That's the only way out in that kind of situation.
Yeah, and that's why you throw that initial fireball first. Because if you see them block it, then they're done. Then they're good.
Then they have to red parry.
Right.
And you can jump out of it if somebody's, you know, messing up on the time. And one of the cool things about this game is that there are lots of throws that are actually combo outable.
Yes.
There you saw one of them with Remy. Necro does that a lot. Hugo can do that a lot, actually. If he stuns in the corner with his neutral throw, he can do a huge damage combo off this.
That's right. Oh, here we go.
Alright, watch out. There he just jumps over. Great reactions.
I mean, the tricky part there is that you have to try to see whether they do the roll or crush or not. Did you just finish them off with the Alex Fire?